Sabaki Ball. I'm Michael Cherpak, inventor of Sabaki Ball, as well as president and CEO of Sabaki Ball International. I'm thrilled to have this opportunity to introduce you to my sport. Sabaki Ball is completely unique to other sports in several important ways, and while it is easy to make comparisons to other established sports, it is important to note the differences if you hope to be successful in playing or coaching Sabaki Ball. One of the remarkable and unintentional aspects of Sabaki Ball is that no matter what traditional sport you may favor, you'll be able to immediately incorporate those skills into Sabaki Ball. The Baki Ball itself is small, light, and a bit slippery, as you can tell by the video. It is made this way so that players who are new to ball sports can be confident that they won't get hurt, while at the same time experienced ball players will be challenged. The object of the sport is to strike the opposing team's goal pin, called a Baki pin, causing it to fall over. Because the Baki pin is protected by a goalie, the backboard, known as a Baki board, allows players to attempt bank shots as well as trying to strike the pin directly. There are several things that make Sabaki Ball extremely unique, so unique in fact that I was awarded a patent on the method of playing the sport. First, in Sabaki Ball, you have to load your shots. This is becoming more and more popular in modified games of traditional sports. Basically, it means that you have to complete a minimum number of passes before your team can attempt to score. In Sabaki Ball, a team must complete a minimum of 3 passes before taking the shot. However, one of the differences between Sabaki Ball and other games with this rule is that when a ball is dropped, it does not interrupt the game, nor does it change possession. In Sabaki Ball, a dropped ball becomes a scrum, kind of like in rugby, where either team has an equal chance to grab the loose ball. Whichever team comes up with the ball, they now have possession and continue to move the ball towards the opposing team's goal pin, reloading their shot. Next is one of the things that makes Sabaki Ball very fast and different from sports like team handball. This is the 3-second clock. Once you gain possession of the ball, you have just 3 seconds to get rid of it, either by passing the ball to another player, taking a shot, or otherwise releasing the ball. Now, the 3-second rule should not be confused with the 3 steps allowed in team handball or ultimate frisbee. Even a tall person can advance the ball only 20 feet or so within 3 steps. However, I'm in my 50s, but I can still run the entire length of a Sabaki Ball court within 3 seconds. So in Sabaki Ball, your feet should always be moving. Think of it more like lacrosse or hockey. Finally, in many sports that use a goalie, the goalie waits while their team is on offense, not in Sabaki Ball. This is one of the hardest things to get used to for new players. When the goalie's team has the ball, the goalie advances to mid-court to become part of the offense. This is called playing the point. Not only does passing to your goalie stretch out the defense, but also goals can be scored from the point. However, the goalie must remember that if a ball goes out of bounds and they are awarded possession, they will have just 3 seconds to sprint back 45 feet to retrieve a new ball. So basically, I took a position that is normally the least utilized and made it into the most active position on the court. It is because of these and a few other unique aspects of the sport that Sabaki Ball has grown to include participation by more than 500,000 people across 30 states here in the U.S. and is being played across Canada and in parts of China and Africa. Being that it has only been 2 years since the patent award, the growth has been tremendous. Most surprising to us has been the number of collegiate Sabaki Ball programs that have sprung up over the past year. Well, thanks for watching my video. Now it's time to get up and get moving. I hope to see you on a Sabaki Ball court someday soon, but until that time, I wish you all the best.